The IGP said it, the Prime Minister said it, and Deputy Prime Minister said it, and they say this, that Jolo is within weeks. They would have got him arrested. They know precisely where he is. Now, if they do that, and today I heard the IGP said by year end, they'll bring him. But by year end, the trial is over. At least from the prosecution angle, the trial is over. So why do that? We are saying you should bring in Jolo, because if you want to be fair about this trial, we want to know from Jolo what exactly transpired. There's so many documents that one can confront this witness as well as Jolo as to whether or not Najib is implicated in the conspiracy to actually defraud 1MDB. The only thing that Jolo is relevant is SRC and 1MDB. And this is finishing. By November, the prosecution perhaps will close the case. So you will bring at the end of the year, what's the use?
So you're saying that if they are very sure of bringing him back, then bring him back first to get what is
bring him quickly so that justice can be given to my client, because I too would like to cross-examine Jolo. Because there's so many things we can confront him with. You heard now, and just think about it, because this evidence came out. Just think about it. Jolo created a fraudulent agreement where overseas, in order, because one of the overseas banks asked him, what is this 700 million for? He was stuck. So he created a fraudulent agreement, management agreement or contract between 1MDB and Goodstar, in order for this money to go into Goodstar account. You ask yourself, do you think Datuk Seri Najib is part of that? Datuk Seri Najib would have to be either the most stupid or the most insane person to do that. This is all Jolo's. You understand that? Yeah? That agreement is a telltale for everything else. Who is in fact behind the conspiracy? Okay? All right. Thank you.